Speaker is now I can say Dr. Gurleen Kaur. She just defended her thesis and from Punjab University, and she will speak to us on construction of a complete and redundant set of Shoda pairs. Gurleen.
Thank you, sir, and thank you to the organizers for organizing such a wonderful event and giving me an opportunity to talk here. So today I'm going to talk on the construction of a complete and redundant set of Shoda pairs. So starting with the basic definition of group algebra, the group algebra FG of a finite group G over a field F. It is the ring of all the formal F linear combinations of the elements of G together with component wise addition and natural way of multiplication. Now consider a field F such that the order of G is invertible in F. Then due to Masky's theorem, FG is a semi-simple ring. That is a direct sum of finite number of minimal two-sided ideals. These minimal two-sided ideals, they are unique in the decomposition and are termed as the simple components of FG. So Vedavan and Artin provided a theoretical description of these simple components. Each simple component is isomorphic to a matrix algebra over a division ring, where the division ring is a finite dimensional division algebra containing an isomorphic copy of F in its center. This decomposition of FG as a direct sum of matrix algebra over division rings is known as the Vedavan decomposition. But it is a theoretical description. It doesn't provide us the knowledge about the DIs, about the NIs. So the basic problem in group algebra is how to provide an explicit description of the simple components of FG. So the first thing which is known in this direction is that if FG is written as a direct sum of simple components AI, then each AI is generated by a non-zero central idempotence EI of FG, where EI satisfy the following, that they are mutually orthogonal. When you sum it up, it's one, and it further can't be broken into two non-zero central mutually orthogonal idempotence. So this set of idempotence are called the primitive central idempotence of FG, abbreviated as the PCIs of FG. So once you know the complete set of PCIs of FG, you generate the ideals with it and you get the simple components, but still you don't know its description in terms of the matrix algebra or division rings. So a fundamental problem in group algebra, it is to explicitly determine the complete algebraic structure of a given semi-simple group algebra, that is its complete set of PCIs and the precise Vedavan decomposition. The problem is of great interest due to its links to various other problems in group rings. For example, in the study of the unit group of the integral group ring ZG, the study of the integral isomorphism problem, the study of error correcting course, there are many more also, the study of normalizer problem, the study of the automorphism group of group algebra, the study of the primitive idempotence of screw rings, and so on. So once we've seen an impact of this problem on various other problems in group rings, we come back to dealing with this problem. So the classical way of determining the primitive central idempotence, it was given by Toshiko Yamaja in 1974. Roughly speaking, he provided a two-step process. The first step is to compute the PCIs of the group algebra F bar G, where F bar denotes the algebraic closure of F using the character table of G, and then compute the PCIs of the semi-simple group algebra FG using a group axiom. But the problem with this method is that the known methods to compute the character table of G, they are very time-consuming. Moreover, we have to compute the Galois group of F chi over F. So due to its limitations in practical applications, a question arises that does there exist any character free description, which means to say a description that is completely within FG, which doesn't involve computation in its character table, nor its Galois group to determine the PCIs of FG. So a standard way of constructing idempotence in a semi-simple group algebra is that if H is a subgroup of G, then H hat is an idempotent of FG, which is central if and only if H is a normal subgroup of G. So in case H is a normal subgroup of G, we have a central idempotent of FG. So this leads one to think that is it possible to obtain the PCIs of FG from the subgroup structure of G? And then many researchers started working in this direction. The storyline starts with finite abelian groups, then naturally proceeding to metacyclic groups, then going further to nilpotent groups, then to abelian by supersurveyor groups, and so on. But a major breakthrough in all this work was achieved by Olivier, Gerio, and Simon for finite monomial groups. A group is said to be monomial if each of its irreducible complex character it is induced from a linear character of some subgroup. And it's a very large class of Stoweber groups. In fact, every finite Stoweber group can be embedded in a monomial group. So Olivier et al. They gave the term soda pair of G, which is a pair of subgroups of G which satisfies the following conditions, which are stated here. And this rephrased the Soda's theorem. Soda's theorem, given by Kenjiro Soda, who was the famous Japanese mathematician, proved that if Xi is a linear character of a subgroup H of G with kernel K, then for every G belonging to G but doesn't belong to H, the character Xi and the conjugate character Xi G, they are distinct on H intersection with the conjugate subgroup HG, which is equivalent to saying, if we look at the definition of Soda pair, that the pair H, K is a Soda pair of G. So they proved that for finite monomial groups, Soda's pairs are sufficient to be able to compute all the PCIs of the rational group algebra. But to go further in this direction, some important terminologies are to be introduced. Let K be a normal subgroup of H, which is a subgroup of G, define H hat as stated. Epsilon HK, which was the main ingredient given by Jespers, Lee, and Bates. And AGHK, which is the sum of all the distinct G conjugates of epsilon HK. So clearly, EGHK being the sum of distinct G conjugates is a central element of QG. And once the distinct G conjugates happens to be mutually orthogonal, then EGHK becomes a central idempotent of QG. So this leads one to think that whether for a soda pair HK of G, EGHK, or a rational multiple of it, it becomes the PCI of QG. And this is what exactly Olivier, Gerio, and Simon proved. That for a soda pair HK of G, alpha EGHK is a PCI of QG, where alpha is a rational number necessarily unique. So for every PCI of QG, for a finite monomial group G, there is a soda pair of G associated to it. But it may happen that two different soda pairs of G, they may give rise to the same PCI of QG. So this leads one to defining an equivalence between the soda pairs and a complete set of representatives of distinct equivalence classes of soda pairs of G is termed as the complete and redundant set of soda pairs. So the fundamental problem, which is determining the explicit description of Verdurbin decomposition, the key step is to determine a complete and redundant set of soda pairs of G. So I come to our work in this direction, which is a joint work with Professor Gurmeet Kaur Bakshi. And in the paper, Vector Peoples and Soda Pairs, published in Journal of Algebra, we have provided a construction of complete set of soda pairs for a large class of monomial groups, which include abelian by supersurveyable as well as subnormally monomial groups, and also a necessary and sufficient condition for the collection of soda pairs of groups in this class to be complete and redundant. So now I will come to this class C of monomial groups. So we have studied the class C of monomial groups. C denotes the class of all finite groups G such that each subquotient of G, it is either abelian or contains a non-central abelian normal subgroup. So Huppert proved that the groups in class C are monomial and is different from the earlier well-known subclass of monomial groups, that is strongly monomial groups, that was introduced by Olivier et al. So we have seen that this class is actually a very large class of monomial groups, for it contains subnormally monomial groups, which as the name suggests are those groups whose all complex irreducible characters, they are induced from linear characters of some subnormal subgroups. Then the Stoweber groups with all its elements of prime power order, the class of Stoweber groups with all its Stiller subgroups abelian, and their extension by super Stoweber groups, and many other technical type of classes too. Here I would like to point out that in 1983, Isaacs gave an example of a monomial group, which is not in class C, of order 2 raised to 15 into 7 sphere, which shows the vastness of the class C of monomial groups. So now for this class, we will see that how the soda pairs are constructed. Here is a brief sketch. Choose a group G in class C, compute all its normal subgroups. Then for each normal subgroup, you construct a rooted directed tree whose certain leaves will correspond to the soda pairs of G. So collect the soda pairs corresponding to the leaves in Gn for all the normal subgroups of G, and that will turn out to be a complete set of soda pairs of G. But then there are some natural questions that in the rooted directed tree, what are the vertices, what are the edges, which leaves are corresponding to the soda pairs of G, how to determine that leaves. So now we will answer these questions. So a fundamental role which has played is the Isaac's notion of connector triple, following which we define an n-linear connector triple of G, which is a connector triple in which further theta is linear and kernel of induced connector, kernel of theta induced to G is n. So we will see that in the tree, these n-linear connector triples will be the vertices, but now we have to define edges. Edges are to be defined in such a way that we reach maximum to the lead redundancy of the set of soda pairs of G. So for that, for the connector triple HA theta, we fix a normal subgroup AHA theta of H of maximal order containing kernel theta, such that the factor group A over kernel theta is abelian. Now, why these conditions have been imposed? The reason is that the group G belongs to the class C, so the subcosent H over kernel theta. And so if H over kernel theta is non-abelian, then due to the property of the groups in class C, that it contains a non-central abelian normal subgroup, we will easily see that this factor group actually is a non-central abelian normal subgroup of H over kernel theta. So if I take a connector on this A, which lies above theta, and I consider the inertial group of that connector in H, it will be a proper subgroup of S since it is a non-central subgroup. And then if I take the Clifford correspondent of the connector on the inertial subgroup, that induced to H is irreducible. But what is happening is that we are coming down. The group H is finite, the process will stop at a certain place, and then we will have a linear connector which induced to H is irreducible. So this is the main idea. And this is a construction of the set CLHA theta, which is a construction of another n-linear connector triples from the connector triple HA theta, which will help us to define edges. And it's a little bit technical construction, so I'm going straight forward to the set CLHA theta, which is the collection of the n-linear connector triples of the type inertial subgroup of phi in H A phi, where phi is a linear connector on A, which lies above theta and has certain other properties too. This is a set if H is not equal to A, but if H is equal to A, we define the set CLHA theta to be an empty set because the process stops there. We get the linear connector. So the connector triples in CLHA theta, they are seen to be a linear connector triples of G, and we call them the direct Clifford correspondents of HA theta. The term direct Clifford correspondents, it refers to the fact that the connectors in this inertial subgroup, they are Clifford correspondents of the connectors in H. So now we come to the construction of soda pairs. Choose a group G in class C and a normal subgroup N of G. Consider the directed graph whose vertex set consists of all the n-linear connector triples of G. And there is an edge in E if V is a direct Clifford correspondent of U. Now clearly Gn, trivial connector of N, it is an n-linear connector triple of G. And therefore it belongs to the vertex set V. So why I'm concentrating on this triple, the reason is that we will construct a directed subgraph of G whose vertex set consists of those vertices for which there is a directed path from this triple Gn trivial connector of N to V, and En to be the set of ordered pairs U, V in E with UV belonging to Vn. So Gn is a directed subgraph of G. And what we have seen is that this Gn is a rooted directed tree with Gn trivial connector of N as its root. The leaves of Gn of the type HS theta, they correspond to the soda pairs of G. Moreover, if I take any soda pair, then there would be a leaf of a certain leaf which will correspond to that soda pair. So more precisely, it means that if I denote by Ln the set of leaves of Gn of the type HS theta, and I say to be the set of soda pairs of G corresponding to the leaves in Ln, then union of Sn and running over all the normal subgroups of G, it is a complete set of soda pairs of G. But then one can ask that whether it is an redundant set of soda pair searching. For this, we define the term good leaf. And we prove that for group G in class C, this set is complete and redundant set if and only if all the leaves, they are good. So here are some facts which are used for the illustrative purposes. And due to time bound, I am going straightforward to the example to illustrate the theory. This is the example of a group of order 1000, which is monomial, the smallest example of monomial group, which is not strongly monomial. It's not abelian by superservable, but it belongs to the class C. And we will show how to construct the set of soda pairs for this group. So firstly, we will compute all the normal subgroups. We can do it using gap. And then for each normal subgroup, we have to construct a duty directed tree. When N1 is G, it is just the vertex GG trivial factor of G. Therefore, these two are equal. It corresponds to the soda pair G, G. When we have the normal subgroups N2, N3, N4, then the factor groups G over Ni, they turn out to be cyclic. And therefore, the rooted directed tree will be just of height 2, which is the soda pair G, Ni. For the normal subgroup N5, the factor group G over N5 is not cyclic, nor even abelian. So we have to do the computations. We compute A. A in such a way that A over N5 is an abelian normal subgroup of maximal order in G over N5. Then we have to compute the set K. K is given in one of the facts. It is a set of all those normal subgroups of N4, which factor group A over K, it is cyclic. Then K intersects with N5 is N5, that is trivial. And code of K in G is N5. But then we have to only choose those subgroups which are distinct up to conjugacy in G. So these are the three subgroups. We have to choose a linear vector on N4 with each of the following kernels. And then we have to compute the inertial subgroups of each this character on G. And each of the inertial subgroup, it turns out to be N4, that is our A. So the process stops here. We get the desired leaves, which is the soda pairs as given. Similarly, for the last normal subgroup, we have to do similar computations till we reach at our duty directed tree, which is the soda pairs as these. So what we have seen, it is a complete set of soda pairs of G. Moreover, all the leaves are good. That is checked easily using gap. There are very simple computations. So it is a complete and redundant set of soda pairs of G. Further, in the description of PCI, we have computed the alpha that is coming in that description. It turns out to be half for these two soda pairs and one otherwise. And we have provided the explicit description of the Verdurbin decomposition of QG, which is as follows. So here are some references which you can look. Thank you. Okay, thank you.
Are there any questions or comments? Yes.
Very good.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay. Well, let's thank and at least virtually clap for Gurleen for this.